Here's a quick look at the latest features and improvements in FlexSim 2025 Update 1. We've improved our NVIDIA Omniverse connector to include simulation object properties as part of your USD file export. This means that data like object connections, processing and setup times, and much more can now be transferred between models using the USD file format. You can now change the class of 3D objects in FlexSim. If you click the icon to the left of an object's name in the Properties view, you can choose a new class for this object. One potential use case for this feature is to turn a shape or prop into a simulation object by giving it a class. It also lays the groundwork for future improvements and interoperability. There are some updates to FlexSim's AGV capabilities that allow you more fine-tuned control in your AGV system models. You can now dynamically change the load type for an AGV, which will adjust the speed the AGV travels at. You can also toggle whether or not a control point is used to wait for travel allocation, so you can choose to use control points more like a trigger point. These can be combined for exciting new workflows. For example, to dynamically change the speed of an AGV when it makes certain turns. There is also a new time travel process flow activity. It's like the travel activity, except that you specify a target time that it will take for this travel task. The task will then adjust the speed of the resource so that it will take that amount of time to reach its destination, provided it isn't impeded, which will add additional time. There's more to explore in this release. Pan the 3D view with the arrow keys on your keyboard. Discover a new pop-up display to see the batches or waves in a process flow activity. We hope you enjoy the latest version of FlexSim.